My Lord Jesus Christ, because of your love for us, you remain night and day in the Blessed Sacrament, full of mercy and of love, waiting for, calling, and welcoming everyone who comes to visit you. I believe that you are present here on the altar. I adore you, and I thank you for all the graces you have bestowed on me, especially for having given me yourself in this sacrament, for having given me your most holy mother, Mary, to plead for me, and for having called me to visit you in this church. I now speak to your most loving heart to thank you for this great gift, and to make amends to you for all the insults given to you in this sacrament by your enemies, promising to adore you in all the places on earth in which you are present in the Blessed Sacrament, and in which you are least honored and most abandoned. My Jesus, I love you with my whole heart. I am very sorry for having refused your infinite goodness so many times. With the help of your grace, I resolve never to offend you again. Unworthy though I now consecrate myself to you without reserve. I renounce my own will, my affections, my desires, and everything that I possess. I give them completely to you. All I ask of you is your holy love, final perseverance, and that I may carry out your will perfectly. I commend to you the souls in purgatory, especially those who had the greatest devotion to the Blessed Sacrament and to the Blessed Virgin Mary. I also pray to you for all poor sinners. Finally, my dear Savior, I unite all my desires with the desires of your most loving heart. I offer them to the Eternal Father and ask Him in your name and for love of you to accept and grant them.
Look, I am standing at the door knocking. Most loving Shepherd, the love you have for your sheep was not satisfied when you sacrificed your life for them on the altar of the cross. That love made you wish to allow yourself to remain on the altar in our churches, hidden in the Blessed Sacrament, so that you might be always near and able to knock at the door of our hearts to enter them. If only I could take the same delight in your closeness to me as the spouse in the Song of Songs did. She says, "In his delightful shade I sit, and his fruit is sweet to my taste." My dear Jesus, if I loved you, if I really loved you, I too should wish never to have to leave the foot of the altar day or night. There, near where you hide your majesty under the visible appearance of bread, I would place myself so that I too would experience the same happiness and heavenly consolation of those who love you. Draw me to yourself by the attraction of your beauty and of the love for us that you show in the Blessed Sacrament. Draw me after you. Let us run. Yes, my Savior, I will ignore people and all the pleasures of earth to come to you in the sacrament of the altar, like shoots of the olive around your table. What fruits of virtue these good people, who in their love remain before the tabernacle, produce in the sight of God. They are like fruitful olives. I am ashamed to come before you, my Jesus, because of my complete lack of virtue. You have commanded that everybody who comes to the altar to honor you should bring a present. No one will appear empty-handed before me. What then am I to do? Am I not to come before you anymore, No, that would not please you. Poor as I am, I will still come to you. You yourself must provide me with the gifts you ask from me. I am well aware that it is not only to reward those who love you that you remain in the Blessed Sacrament. You wish also to provide from the riches of your grace for those who are lacking in virtue. Very well. Let us start today. I adore you, King of my heart. You are the true lover of us all, the shepherd who loves his sheep so much. It is to this throne of your love I now come. Since I have no other present to give you, I offer you my poor heart, that it may be consecrated entirely to loving you and to doing your will. With all my heart, I want to give you my love, and I really wish to love you as much as I can. Take it then to yourself, and shape it to fully doing your will. From today onward, may I be able to rejoice in the fact that I, like your esteemed disciple St. Paul, am a prisoner in the bonds of your love. I, Paul, am the prisoner of the Lord Jesus. Unite me, my Lord, to yourself. Make me forget about myself so that one day I may have the happiness of becoming completely detached from everything, even myself, so as to find you and love you forever. I love you, my Jesus, in the Blessed Sacrament. It is to you I join and unite myself. Help me to love you more and never depart from me.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Most Holy Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as being already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Jesus, name above all names. St. Bernard speaks of Mary as being the safe road which will lead us to the Savior and to our own salvation. Since it is true, my Queen, that you are the one who brings our souls to God, you cannot expect me to come nearer to God unless you carry me in your arms. Carry me. Carry me. And if I resist you, carry me by your own strength. In your own loving way, do all in your power to force my heart and my rebellious will to give up created things and to seek only God and His holy will. Show all heaven the greatness of your power. Your mercy has made you perform many miracles of grace. Show everyone in heaven how powerful you are. Let it be known that after all the other miracles, you can do one more, bringing close to God someone who has lived far from Him. Mary, you can make me a saint. I trust you to do it.
Most Holy Virgin Immaculate, my Mother Mary, you are the Mother of my Lord, the Queen of the world, the Advocate, the Hope, and the Refuge of sinners. I, who am most in need of mercy, come before you today. I offer you my respectful devotion, and I thank you for all the graces you have granted to me until now. In particular, I thank you for saving me from hell, which I have so often deserved by my sins. I love you, most lovable Lady. Because of my love for you, I promise to honour you always and to do all in my power to make sure that others also love you. In your hands, I place all my hopes. I entrust the saving of my soul to your care. Accept me as your servant, Mother of Mercy. Take me under your mantle. Since you have such power with God, save me always from temptation, or rather, obtain for me, until my death, the strength to overcome them. Of you, I ask the grace of a perfect love for Jesus Christ. With your help, I hope to die a happy death. My Mother, I beg you, by the love you have for God, to help me at all times, but especially at the last moment of my life. Do not leave me, I plead with you, until you see me safe in heaven, blessing you and singing your mercy for eternity. Amen. That is my hope. May it be so.